SGLT2 inhibitors. These are new classes of oral antidiabetics which acts by an entirely different mechanism. We know that the proximal convoluted tubule absorbs most of the filtered substrates. It is here that glucose is also getting absorbed. So if we stop this glucose absorption, this glucose will be lost in the urine. As a result, your glycemic control can be achieved. There are two types of SGLT, that is sodium glucose transporter protein 1 and 2. One is found in both intestine as well as kidney, and two in kidney. This two accounts for 90% of the glucose that is reabsorbed. So any drugs that stop this, that inhibits this SGLT2, can give you glycemic control. Three drugs are canagliflozin, dapagliflozin and empagliflozin. So the more the sugar is lost in the urine, the more the chance of getting UTI, that is urinary tract infections. So this is one class of drug which can cause UTI as the side effect. This not only prevents this glucose absorption, it also inhibits the sodium absorption. That is, the name itself tells you it is sodium and glucose transporter protein inhibitors. So when sodium is lost, your BP also can be controlled. So this drug offers you dual benefit. Though it is not used as a antihypertensive, apart from the glycemic control, it can give you BP control also.